हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डे 21st ऑफ जुलाई लीड को चैलेंज। एंड टुडेस क्वेश्चन इज पुश डोमिनोज। इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी आर गिवन डोमिनोज इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन ऑफ साइज एन एंड वी हैव अप्लाइड फ्यू फोर्सेस ऑन दीज डोमिनोज एट रैंडम ईदर इन लेफ्ट डायरेक्शन और द राइट डायरेक्शन। वी नीड टू टेल वट वुड बी द टोटल इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दीज फोर्सेज ऑन दीज डोमिनोज एंड देर आर फ्यू कॉन्स्टेंट्स दैट वर गिवन टू अस। If a domino has both the effects, the left and the right one, then the total effect on the domino will be nullified by the left force and the right force. The other constraint that is specified in the question is if you apply a force on a particular domino in one particular direction, it gets propagated to its adjoining domino in that direction. You'll understand it as I'll walk through the presentation. So I'll discuss those examples and we'll try to come up with the approach through those examples in the presentation. So without much ado, let's look at the presentation that I have created for this. Push dominoes, lead code 383. And let's walk through the basic example that was specified in the question. We have applied right force on this domino. Again, a right force on this domino. We have applied no force right now on this domino and we have applied left force on this domino. We want to tell what would the final state of this particular domino. As you can see that this particular domino is under the influences of two forces, one from the right, other one from the left. That means the overall impact on this domino will be null and void. It will cancel out each other, the left force and the right force, as a result of which we'll have that domino standing upright, which is represented by a dot. An inference that we can take from this, left and right can cancel each other. I am specifically saying can cancel each other. There are other cases as well. Let's try and understand those cases in the next example. This is the second example that is specified in the question. We have something, the dominoes like this. Dot, left, dot, right, dot, 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 left, right, dot, dot, left, dot, dot. I am writing the left forces on the top, the right ones at the bottom. So let's start the process. Since I am moving in the left direction, I am starting from the leftmost terminal going up till the zeroth index. This domino is not under the influence of any left force, will stay as it is. This domino is not under the influence of any left force, no incoming left force on this domino. This domino is under the influence of left force itself. It will percolate this left force to its adjoining domino on the left, on its left. So we have left here, left force coming here as well, left force coming here as well. You will observe that at this particular index, we are already applying a right force, so this indirect left incoming force will not have any impact. Rather, we are applying right force on it. We'll understand it we'll iterate from the zeroth index up till the right one, moving in the right direction. Let's forget it right now. Next, we have the left force on this particular domino. Let's move ahead. Here, we'll have an indirect left force coming from its left. Here, we'll have an indirect force coming from its left. Again, we'll have an indirect left force coming from its left. Again, we witnessed a right force, right direct force. Let's forget it. We'll come to it when we'll move in the reverse direction, in the right direction. This domino is not under the influence of any left force. Move ahead. Here we are applying a direct left force on this particular domino. This force will be percolated on its left. So this also have a left indirect force coming on it. Let me change the color of the pen and start the iteration in the other direction. So is this domino under the influence of any right force? It's not. So there is no right force here. This domino has direct left force, so no right force here. It's empty. This domino is also upright, no right force, move ahead. This domino has direct impact of the right force, So this will be percolated to its right, here, here, here. Next we have is a direct left force, move ahead. Next we have is right, direct right force. It will be percolated to its right, here, here, here. Next we have left, forget it. These two don't have any right force incoming, so we'll stay as it is. So I'm marking cross here, cross here, cross here, because there no indirect or direct right forces are present. Here as well, here as well, here we have a right force, sorry. No right force, no right force, no right force. Let's also do the same thing for the left ones. I haven't highlighted the one which do not have any incoming force. So this doesn't have any incoming force, any left force, no incoming left force, no incoming left force, no incoming left force, no incoming left force. Now comes the comparison. Let's start build. We can build the answer now. So let's start with this particular index, starting from the zero, going up till the last end of the input array. So which force is present here? We can see left arrow and a cross. Cross signifies no right force. We only have a left force, so left will be filled in here. We already have a direct left force on it, so left will be filled in here. We do not have any force in right or left, since both of them are cross. It will stay as it is, as dot. Here we have a direct right source, so right will be filled in here. Here we have both the forces, left and right. Which one is the closest one? The right one or the left one? So the nearest left is farther away for this particular index, whereas right is immediately adjoining. You can see here we have a right force and this left force is way far off. So what is the difference? Left force is at 3 units away, 1, 2, and 3. Right force is 1 unit away. So which one will have a stronger impact? The right one. So we'll get right here. Let's talk about this particular case. Let me just change the color of pen once again. It's not very clear. Let's take black. We are talking about this particular entry, and we have both the arrows as valid, the left one and the right one. How far is the right force? 2 units. How far is the left force? 2 units. So what will you get? It will stand upright because the force on the left and the right are equivalent. So you'll get dot here. Let's move ahead. Next we have this particular index. We have an indirect left force and an indirect right force. Both the arrows are valid. And what is the distance of its right force? The distance of right force is 3 units. The distance of left force is 1 unit. Which one is stronger? The left one is stronger because it is closest. So we'll get L at this position. Let's move ahead. Let's move ahead with the process. We have left, direct left. Left will come, direct right, right will come. Let's talk about this particular index. We have both the forces, right indirect and left indirect, under the influence of this particular index. Right indirect is 1 unit away, 1 unit away. Left indirect is 2 units away. Which will be stronger? The one that is closest, that means right will come into picture since it is nearest. So we'll write R here. Let's continue the process. Next we have this particular index. We have both the forces on this particular domino, the left one and the right one, both indirect in nature. Left force is 1 unit away, right force is 2 units away. Which one have a stronger impact? The one that is closest. That means you will get left here, L here, left force here. Let's continue the process. We have direct left force here, we'll write left. We don't have any forces on the last two dominoes, so that will stand upright, dot and dot. The answer becomes L, L dot, R or dot, L, L, R, R, L, L, dot, dot. which is as expected as per the output of the example that was given in the question. Can you write the algorithm by yourself now? I would highly recommend you guys to stop the video. You know the algorithm, what we are going to do. Just go and code it up. If you find it difficult, come back and move the video ahead. I hope you were able to do it by yourself. But if in case not, don't worry. Let's do exactly the same thing what I specified in the previous slide. So I am writing the indirect left forces here, the indexes of indirect left forces, the indexes of indirect right forces, and depending upon these values, we'll build our answer. Since we are moving in the left direction first, we'll fill in the entries for nearest left forces in this blue array. So let's get started. The 13 index, we have a dot. It doesn't have any impact. It's standing upright. So we'll fill in minus 1 here. Let's continue the process. We'll fill in minus 1 here. Next, we have a left force. We have a direct left force here at index 11. So we'll fill in 11 here. This will be transferred to its left. So at 10, we have a dot. That means the impact will come from its left, and we'll fill in 11 here. Next, we have again a dot on its left. An indirect force is coming from its left. We'll fill in 11 here. Next, we have R. R is a direct right force. We have to stop the process of the indirect left force coming, and we'll fill in minus 1 here since we have direct right force at this particular index. Next, we have a direct left source. It will get updated. The index will get updated to 7. Since that is a direct left force. This left force will be percolated to its left. We have a dot here. 7 will be copied. Next, we have again a dot. 7 will be copied. Next, we have again a dot. 7 will be copied. Next, we have is a right. Direct right force. We'll update it to minus 1. Because it's not a left force, it's a right force, and whatever indirect left force was coming, that will be null and voided as soon as you encounter a right force. We have a dot here. There is no left force on this particular dot, so we'll fill in minus 1 here. Next, we have left at an index 1, so we'll have 1 here. Next, we have a dot, so left force will come over here as an indirect impact, and we'll update it to 1. We have built the array with the value of those indexes that are actually causing an indirect or direct left force on the current domino. Let's repeat the process for the right indexes as well. And let's start. The first one is a dot. That means it doesn't have any right force coming at this particular index. We'll fill in minus 1 here. Next, we have a direct left force, no particular right force, we'll fill in minus 1 here. Again, we'll fill in minus 1 here since there is no right force coming up. We have a direct right force at this particular index, so we'll fill in 3 here. This force will be transferred to its right, we'll fill in 3 here since we have a dot here. This will be propagated to its adjoining positions, 3, 3. It will stop at this particular index since we have a direct left force coming up, so we'll fill in minus 1 here. Then we'll fill in 8 here. 8 gets transferred to its adjoining right. 8 stop since we encountered a left, and we'll update it to minus 1. There is no right force. Minus 1 signifies there is no right force here as well. There is no right force here as well. There is no right force. Now we have built in both the arrays, and let's try and build the solution depending upon which one is the closest to the current index. Let's get started. We have a left force at this particular index, right is minus 1, so we'll fill in L here. Next, we have 1 here and minus 1 here, we'll fill in L here. We have minus 1 here and minus 1 here. Both are not under the influence of any left or right force. We'll fill in dot. Next we have minus 1 here and 3 here. That means we have a right force. So we'll fill in R here, not 3, R. Let's continue the process. We have 3, we have 7 index coming from the left and we have 3 index coming from its right. Which one is closest to 4? Out of 3 and 7, 3 is closest. So we'll fill R here. Let's continue the process. We have 7 and we have 3. Which one is closest to 5? Both are at equal distance. That means we'll fill in dot here. Let's continue the process. We have 7 and we have 3. Which one is closest to 6? 7 is closest to 6. So we'll fill in left. Next we have 7 and minus 1. We'll fill in left. Next we have minus 1 and 8. We'll fill in right. Next we have 11 and 8. Which one is closest to 9? We have 8 closer to 9 than 11. That means we'll fill in right. Next we have 11 and 8. Which one is closest to 10? 11 is closest to 10. We'll fill in left. Next we have 11 and minus 1. We'll fill in left. Next we have minus 1 comma minus 1. We'll fill in dot since both of them are equal. Minus 1 and minus 1. No force. We'll fill in dot. This becomes the answer which was expected. And without much ado, let's code it up. The time complexity for this approach would be order of n, and the space complexity again would be order of n. The solution looks lengthy, but it's very simple, guys. Just give it a shot, you'll understand it fully, and exactly do the same thing that I specified in the algorithm. The first thing here is define the length, count the number of dominoes that we have. I have created two arrays, one for the left part, one for the right part. And I initialized a variable nearest left index to minus 1. If I encounter the current domino as left, I update the nearest left index to the current index under consideration, that is I. If I find out that the current domino is right, I update the nearest left index value to minus 1, and I simply assign this left index value to left of I. Let's continue the process. I'm exactly doing the same thing for the right direction as well. I have defined another variable, nearest right index. I start iterating from the 0th index going up till the terminal end position of the array. I check out what is the current domino type. It is left or right. If it is left, I update the nearest right index to minus 1. Otherwise, I update the nearest right index to the current index under consideration. I assign the value of right at I equals to nearest right index. I have created the character array for storing the answer. As I start iterating from the 0th index going up till the terminal position of the input array. If the current domino is equal to dot, then I check which one is the closest to the current domino, and I'll pick up the one whichever the left force or the right force, whichever is closest. If my current domino is either left or right, I simply assign that value to my answer. And let's talk about this particular case where we are finding the one that is closest to the current domino when we have a dot at the current domino. I pick out the index of the nearest left index, the nearest right index. I check if I find the difference between the nearest left index versus I, similarly nearest right index versus I. And in case my nearest left index turns out to be equal to minus 1, that means there was no indirect or direct left force at the current index, I update this left diff to maximum value. Similarly for the right diff part as well. In case the right difference is equal to the left difference, that means we have both the forces at this particular index at equal distance, and I update the ANS to dot. If the left one distance is lower, that means the left force is stronger, I update the ANS to L, otherwise I update the answer to right. In the end, I simply return the string format of the answer. And let's try this up. accepted. I hope you enjoyed today's session. If you did, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for viewing it. Have a great day ahead and stay tuned for more updates from Coding Decoded. I'll catch you tomorrow with another fresh question with July Lead Code Challenge. And congratulations, we have crossed almost 2/3 of the July Lead Code Challenge without any fail. And please guys, maintain the consistency. Consistency is very important. All the best. Goodbye.